This next contest is for 2 minute rounds of boxing in the lightweight division. Introducing to you firstly, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the multicolored shorts. At the weight she scaled 9 stone 6 pounds 8 ounces. Today is her 59th professional appearance in a boxing ring. Hailing from Katowice, Poland, presenting Karina Kopinska. And opposing her, boxing out on the red corner, wearing the green plush shorts trimmed with gold and white. At the weight she scaled 9 stone 9 pounds 2 ounces, a perfect unblemished record. 2 contests 2 wins. Here is the undefeated sensation from Wigan, Rhiannon Dixon. Timekeeper at the bell, Burnley's Gary Grennan, and without question, the finest referee in charge of the action, star referee John Latham from Bury. 4 2 minute rounds.
So we've got 4 2-minute rounds here at lightweight. Rhiannon Dixon, first fight with Anthony Crawler in a corner. Long time out of the ring as well. It's looking back here, December 2019 since she made her second appearance. So with the obvious pandemic problems, Rhiannon's been out of action for a little while, but training hard, and I think we can expect to see some fast hands, some nice head movement and some good footwork from Rhiannon.
Oh yeah, she's an exciting fighter. She's always looking for opportunities as well. I've just noticed her opponent has actually been quite active. So could be a good little test for Rhiannon.
Yeah, Kopinska fought Katie Healy not too long ago. Katie got the win over her on, I think it was Katie's professional debut, but you know, Rhiannon, when a professional takes a jab there, a debut opened a lot of people's eyes. No one quite knew what to expect from her because she didn't have a big amateur background. It was all white collar and unlicensed, I think. She came out with lots of head movement, beautiful left hand, and really looked the part. And the hype's only built really since then.
It certainly has. You know, she puts the combinations together really well. As you can see, she's just always looking to just find that opening. And she's aggressive and she's exciting to watch. But of course, after you've been out the ring a while, you need to just sort of ease back into it a little bit, don't you?
Yeah.
She's been training really hard. Seen her working over there in Astley with Anthony.
She's got clipped a couple of times so far, hasn't she? Kopinska found her with a jab and just landed a little right hand as well. Just trying to find that timing, find that distance. But you can see what the weapon is, Guy. You can see the straight left is the weapon.
Yeah, she's also got a really nice right hand to the right hook to the body as well, which she puts in after it. She puts the shots together nicely.
What did impress on her debut, she had head movement, but she was punching off that head movement. No, she wasn't. It wasn't trying to draw her feint and then not countering. She was moving in, moving out, moving left and right, but also throwing that right hook and straight left hand off her head movement.
Yeah, and she's closing the range down here.
Nice composed round here for Rhiannon Dixon. Didn't rush anything. Lots of footwork. Took a couple of little shots, but nothing to be overly concerned about, and probably look to step up the tempo as we go.
Some good tunes on tonight, John.
Yeah. What you get from VIP Aki on a Sunday afternoon. Where would you rather be?
Nowhere, mate. I'd rather be nowhere else.
Than listening to the monkeys in Bolton's White Hotel.
You couldn't write that script, could you? To be honest, though, great turnout. And everyone is in fine fettle today. And it's good to see, isn't it, on the small circuit. There's been, I think, 3 shows in Manchester over this weekend. And they've all been well attended.
Yeah, I think people are just desperate for a day or a night out, aren't they?
Yeah.
You know, I think just speaking to lads who've got tickovers today, they've all done 150, 200 tickets.
Yeah.
But mates, people are just desperate to get out and see live sport again.
Yeah, definitely. And it's good to see because we have had a long period of restrictions, haven't we? So it's great to see everybody here today. That's a good left hand to the body there, straight left hand to the body.
Just got clipped a little again. On a way in, didn't she, Rhiannon, there? Just got to keep those hands up when she makes her way in.
She's probably a bit eager to put on a show, isn't she, in front of her? Because I know she's got a good amount of support here with her tonight.
Looks for a little lead right hook there with a left hand following it afterwards. Something noticeable I've noticed about Rhiannon, she's really looking to get the body shots off, isn't she? She's really exaggerating, leaning over, trying to get around those elbows.
There's a nice little short body shot there, beautiful, and a good right, a good left hook.
Come from working with Anthony Crawler, you know.
Yeah.
Body attack was a big part of Crawler's game, wasn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I'll never forget the Barroso fight, even the Perez fight, Darlis Perez, when he won the title. I think Rhiannon's in the groove now, isn't she?
Yeah, she found her range, found her mark a little bit more, hasn't she?
She's kind of looking to stalk her opponent now, isn't she? Just getting the foot speed going.
Does plenty of top-class sparring, Rhiannon, doesn't she? She's in Gallagher's gym a lot, sparring with the likes of Natasha Jonas. And speaking to Anthony Crawler, he says the sparring sessions between Tasha and Rhiannon are unbelievable, really. You know, you wouldn't imagine with such a vast level of difference in experience, Rhiannon's really coming on in leaps and bounds.
Yeah, and that's a good sign for the future, isn't it? This Karina Kopinska, though, she's playing a part at the minute. She's started off quite well, but now obviously the quality's starting to tell, isn't it?
Yeah, every whenever Rhiannon just starts to get into a little bit of a rhythm, Kopinska just lands something to just act as a little reminder to Rhiannon. You know, if it was a little, Rhiannon did well there, nice little attack on the ropes, but Kopinska just put a little right hand in just to keep her alert, didn't it? Perfect little opponent for your comeback after almost 2 years out.
Yeah, yeah. You mentioned the signing with Matchroom. That's a big deal, that, you know. That's a really important, massive platform they're working with now. And in women's boxing, we, you know, speaking to Rhiannon about this not too long ago, in a few fights' time, she could find herself in a real meaningful title fight. So the future is bright for her. She plays the cards right.
Oh, yeah. Obviously, the relationship with Crawler's going to give you opportunities. You're going to get noticed quicker, but you've got to be able to fight. And so far, Rhiannon's shown that she can. But when you look at girls like Amy Timlin fighting for the European title last night, opportunities have come pretty quickly. And I know Amy had a much longer amateur background and was involved in combat sports before, but 21-year-old girl on a big stage last night.
Absolutely.
And Rhiannon's going to get an opportunity.
That's exactly right. It was great to see her getting that opportunity. Unfortunately, it wasn't a night, but, you know, as you say, in a female boxing world, in the boxing pool, you can come back from those sorts of fights.
No, Kopinska just looking to get on the front foot a little bit more. Another little nice right hand.
Yeah, that's good right hand from her there.
Be good to see Rhiannon on the back foot. In both her appearances so far, she's been the one looking to come forward. Beautiful little
that
right
hand. That was lovely there. You see, she dipped a little bit. Oh, took a right hand as well back, but this is good. This is what we want to see, really. Dust the cobwebs off. Nice body shot.
Right hook to her body's become a big weapon for Rhiannon Dixon, hasn't it, during this two years out. It was a little bit like don't text in saying I'm making comparisons, boxing fans alike. But when Manny Pacquiao burst onto the scene, he was all about that straight left hand. That's all it was. He had one weapon. It was a big straight left hand.
That's right, yeah. Until Freddie Roach coached him out of it, didn't he? Yeah. But yeah.
So it's these fighters, don't matter what level you start the game at, as you go on, you pick up more and more weapons and you realise when to use them. And Rhiannon Dixon adding little extra little bits to a game, which is, you would imagine, the improvements are going to be, well, she's going to skyrocket considering she had virtually no amateur background.
Oh, definitely. And considering how long she's been out of the ring as well, she's finding her feet well here. She's controlled the ring generalship and a lot of elements of this fight. It's just, you know, I feel like with a bit of activity, you'll start to see what she's really about when she looks razor sharp like she did in her professional debut. She looked razor sharp that night.
Yeah. Another good round in the bank there. Saying good round because this is absolutely priceless experience that Rhiannon Dixon's getting here. She's got a decent opponent in who's not on the back foot, not on the defensive. She's constantly looking to land her own little punches, and Rhiannon's having to think and work through these new tactics that Crawler's trying to instill into her.
Yeah, and that's crucial, isn't it? It's crucial to get the learning experiences early on in the career, isn't there? There'd be no point in there coming in there smashing someone in 20 seconds. She shouldn't have learned anything from that. So yeah, a good bit of matchmaking here because, like I say, the opponent's fresh, sharp, she's been active, she's come with a bit of her own ambition, and it's exactly what Rhiannon needed.
Yeah, and if this matchroom debut is just less than a month away now, well, she's going in well prepared. You wouldn't want to go in with 30 seconds action, a one round action. You know, she's had a nice little fight here, nice little rush header, and she should fly into that date in October in Liverpool.
She's very marketable, of course, as well. She's great on camera, she talks well, and I think the Liverpool fans are going to like her.
Are we all fourth and final round here? I think we can see Kopinska's going to look to land a straight right hand, Rhiannon Dixon's going to look to land a right hand to the body and back straight left. Seen that right uppercut's worked nicely a couple of times, hasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. She has varied her shots. She's varied her shots tonight. You get the sense she's working on a few things as well, you know, that her and Crawler have been working on.
Yeah, is that straight left hand? Couple of little left hands again then.
Yeah.
That right up to the body, I just wonder if part of... It's one thing learning to throw it, the other thing is learning the right time to throw it. And there's just been a couple of times where there's not been a set up for it. She maybe led with it a little bit and just got clipped a couple of little times with left hooks in return.
I think a lot of it's just wanting to impress her fans and, you know, put on a show, because that's what she likes. She really does care about her fans and followers. So that's the one little error, isn't it, just to have a little look at. A couple of those, getting clipped a couple of times, but
nothing major, nothing to worry about. Very experienced. Can we call her a journey woman, Karina Kopinska?
Well, she's far better than a lot of journey women, yeah. I've seen, like, well, the majority of them, and you know, she's experienced. That's a good left hand then from Rhiannon straight down the pipe. And another one.
Yeah, beautiful. Just found a mark for that straight left hand. I don't think really she could have asked for much more there, Rhiannon Dixon. She got a good opponent, good four rounds under her belt. First fight with a new coach in the corner, and she's got a big fight on the horizon.
Yeah, and she had to work. And great preparation for a good turnaround in October there.
And well done, Karina Kopinska, as well.
Oh, definitely, definitely.
Michael Pass, RMC Fudale, will just be collecting the scores. I think it's pretty academic. I think Rhiannon Dixon's going to go to 3-0 here. But a nice little workout.
I do apologise for the late entrance. The cakes are very nice. You just turn the mic up a little bit, please, Rob. Ladies and gentlemen, after four rounds of lightweight action, star referee John Latham has scored the contest 40 points to 36 points for your winner. Hailing from Wigan, now undefeated in three professional contests, Rhiannon Dixon.
And there we have it, John.
Your appreciation, please, for Poland's Karina Kopinska.
Yep. There we go.
Good win tonight, and onwards and upwards. Look forward to seeing Rhiannon back in action.
Yeah, be very pleased with that. Anthony Crawler will be very pleased with that. Lots to work on. Get back in the gym on, well, I assume pretty quickly, maybe back in on Monday. Start working on those little things, ready for a Liverpool.
John, it's been a pleasure. I'll catch you later on.
Yeah, we've got a revolving seat here in the co-commentary position. Aki Cream's leaving, and Jake Goodwin is going to join us now for the next fight. We'll be back in a minute.
For all boxing info, news and latest interviews, amateur and pro, across the north, click and subscribe. VIP Boxing Promotions. Also, Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.